So first question is the hardest.
What? Please say and spell your name for me.
My name is Chris Childs. H-R-I-S-C-H-I-L-D-S. Sorry. But I'm the president of the Five Points Ferret Revolution.
Oh, great.
In Indianapolis, Indiana.
Great.
So go ahead and introduce your little friend.
This is Spellcaster Von Derpalicious, and he's one of our little throwaway ferrets. He came into the shelter because somebody threw him out in the snow
in January. So I fell in love when
I adopted him. And he won first in Panda Mutt Plays.
So you go ahead and look at me the whole time. And I'm just going to ask you a couple questions. So tell me, why do you think some people aren't as open to having, you know, ferrets as a pet rather than like cats or dogs or the traditional types of pets?
There's a common misnomer that ferrets stink, and they don't, because most are from Marshall's Farms, and they're de-sexed and de-scented from a very early age, so they don't. There's really not much of a smell to them. There can be if you don't keep their cages clean, of course, but you can say that about all animals. Other people believe that they're bitey. They can be at very first, but you train them out of it, just like a puppy. They mouth. They are mischievous. They are incredibly intelligent. I mean, they are escape artists. But you just have to try to figure out how to be smarter than they are. It is possible. And I highly recommend people talk to a ferret refuge or shelter in their area, because they can get tips on how to take care of them. Pet stores don't normally have the best advice necessarily.
What would you say sort of convince someone to consider a ferret if they're typically a cat or a dog person?
Ferrets, I think, are much cuddlier and they have very sweet personalities. I mean, I have a cat and a dog and 10 ferrets. And the ferrets, they each have their own unique personalities. And I just think they're a lot more fun than the cat or the dog. And I've had other cats and dogs, they aren't my first. But they're just, I don't know, there's something magical about them. And they're very, very empathetic. If I get sick, my ferrets, we have a free roam area. Our family room is sectioned off. Our ferrets will come up and
the adolescents, we're still missing ferrets 202. And 211. 202 and 211. We'll bring your ferrets to the judging area and a carrier.
They'll lay with me and they'll give me kisses. You won. Act like they're trying to make me feel better. They're very empathetic.
You're answering all my questions before I can even ask them. So, all right, last couple questions. So about the law in California. If you could say anything to the lawmakers or to the voters, you know, what would you say to kind of win them over and to, you know, getting ferrets be legalized?
Truthfully, I don't understand why they wouldn't be legal, because they, when they're both cared for, they're incredibly sweet, amazing, wonderful pets. I've seen more
passport pop specialty. Again, we have called the passport hog specialty, so if you're judging in that ring, please get your ferret ready.
Hi!
Oh my god.
I've seen dogs that cause more damage and harm, and they're scarier and more vicious, where ferrets in general are much sweeter and nicer, and they can be emotional support animals. I have a friend who has epilepsy, and her ferret tells her when she's going to have a seizure. So I really think they're incredibly amazing creatures, and I really just don't understand why they would be illegal in the first place.
Yeah.
Is there anything you want to add?
thing is, I would never ever live in California with a law against ferrets because my ferrets are literally that important to me.
Yeah, it's a little Harry Potter.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.